Welcome to Dandelion Cottage. Today is marvelous Monday. And I'm Leslie Watkins. Thank you for joining me today. I thought I would take you to a trip to the ocean and do a little fantastic undersea adventure. So let me show you what I've got for you today. I'm using the Seaside Notions stamp set. I also have the dies from Smooth Sailing, and I'm going to be using this seaweed. And I have the 3D Seabed embossing folder. I also have the Well Done stamp set, and I'm going to be using these little fish and maybe the seahorse and the coral and so forth. So we've got that. And I'm going to be using a lot of things from the Seaside Notions stamp set. So to get ready for today, I took a piece of watercolor paper and I put a little bit of a wash on it. So I've got just a kind of a sea green blue background and a little warmer tone for the sand at the bottom. And then I've got another scrap of watercolor paper. And this is, well, let me give you the dimensions. So this larger one measures 5 1/4 by 4. And this one is 5 1/4 by 1 1/2, roughly. And then I have some other scraps. And these are just odds and ends of watercolor paper that I had left over from, you know, other projects. And I just put a little wash on them. So this one has a kind of a yellow and red pinkish tone. And this is just the yellow and the blue to get some variation and gradations. And I'm going to begin by taking my large piece. Let me just move some of these things out of the way so we can have some room to work here. I'm going to take my die cutting machine. And it, just as a reminder, it's just a few more days now before the new die cutting machine will be available. So that's going to be very exciting. I'm just checking my settings here, make sure that we're broadcasting. Okay. And for this, I'm going to swap out my magnetic platform and cutting plates. And I'm going to go back to the original platform, and I'm going to use the blue violet 3D embossing plates. So let me get my folder out. Now there's two different kinds of folders. There's the regular embossing folder, and then there's the 3D, and the 3D is extra thick, and so when you use this folder, you want to have this setup that I'm using today. So now before I put that in, I just want to take a look at it. So there is a right way, an upside and a downside to my eye when I look at this. So I want to get a lot of these seaweed fronds sort of going up towards the top. So I want to capture those. So I'm just arranging my paper in there to get the design that I want. Okay. And then using the folded edge first towards the roller and placing, get that in there, and then place the blue plate on top of that. I'm going to run that through. Now the paper where I painted that little wash is still slightly damp, and that's going to help to get a nice impression. Now, I think you can see, if I show you the back here, I think you can really see how that came out. And actually, I put it in upside down, so that's kind of a bummer. But it gives me a chance to show you from the beginning what I did. So let me start again, because I don't want to give you bad advice here. So here's a piece of watercolor paper, and all I did, and I'm just going to use this one to measure. Now I want the decal edge to go towards the bottom. So I'm going to do it this way. So I'm just taking my thumbnail and I'm putting a little mark on the side of the paper to show me where to fold it. I'm going to use my bone folder. And I will be able to use this one on the next card, but I have to paint it again, and I don't want to be too wet because it won't dry in time for what I want to show you here today. I'm just going to tear this strip off, and then using this as a guide, just tear it down. And the bone folder is going to help give you that nice sharp edge so that you get a good clean tear. So there we go. So all I'm doing now is I'm taking a little bit of some blue with a little bit of yellow in it. And I'm just going to put a light wash. I'm adding a little more yellow over on the sides. And then down towards the bottom, I'm adding my pink and my sort of yellowish pink mixture for the sand at the bottom. And I want to be careful to get the color all the way to the edges, because I'm not going to cut those off. I want those to be part of the overall texture of the piece. And I'm adding just a little deeper color here as we get down towards the bottom of the ocean. And again, the yellow on the sides, because that's where our seaweed's going to be. There we go. All right, so it's just that easy. Now I'm going to put this aside to dry a little bit. And while that is drying, I'm going to take some of my scraps. And this time, I'm going to go back to my magnetic plate. And my regular cutting plate. And I'm going to take my seaweed dye. Now I might be able to get two off of this piece. So let me see if I can get two. Pull this out, and this is still slightly damp too, so I'm being very careful. I don't want to tear it. There we go. Let's see if I can fit another one on there. Just the top part, that's okay. That will work. These die cuts are so wonderful. They make so many, give you so many possibilities to create texture and just all sorts of added interest to your cards. Now I am going to grab my piercing tool and make sure that I get those extra little pieces out of there. Okay. Go. Now I don't know that we'll need another one, but since we've got everything out, I'm just going to go ahead and pass this through one more time, because you never know when these little things are going to be handy. And I just, you know, I have a collection of some of these extra bits that I cut out or stamp, and I just keep them in a little clear envelope so I can see what's in there, and then as I need them I can grab them. So there we go, there's our seaweed. And let's check out our other piece. Now this time I'm going to look more carefully at the folder. So what's happened, what I did was I didn't pay attention. The side of the folder that has the logo on it is the top or the right side, and I had put it in this way. So don't make the mistake I made. So let me show you how to do it correctly. So here's my watercolor wash that I did a minute ago. And again, I'm going to look for those fronds of seaweed and place it just where I want it, up towards the top here. Okay. In it goes. Let me get that straight. This is a really large folder. It's 6 by 6 1/4, so you can get a nice piece of embossed pattern out of there. And being that it's oversized, it gives you a chance to cut out just the part that you want, which makes it very convenient. Okay, so fingers crossed, and there we go. That's exactly how it should be. I think you can see that. It's really beautiful. I just love this folder. And so now what I want to do is I'm going to take my watercolors and I'm just going to add a little bit of detail to some of these bits of seaweed. So I'm just going to put just a couple of touches here and there. And because the paper is still slightly damp, I'm going to get a nice soft blending of some of these colors. And I can take a little bit of the red and the yellow and mix up a kind of a pale orange. And I'm going to use a few touches of this on the coral. Let me put you down a little so you can see better. Now, not all of this will show. There we go. Just a little bit extra, not just nothing too detailed. A little bit up here. And maybe this one over here I missed. Okay. Now I'm going to take my card base, and this is a landscape tent fold. So this card measures 5.5 by 4.25. The full size is 8.5. It's scored at 4.25. And then I have a piece of Pretty Peacock. I'm going to use this as my mat. And this is just 1/8 of an inch smaller than my card base. So using my Tombow liquid glue, I'm just going to flip my watercolor over, and I'm just going to use a piece of paper towel to make sure there's no wet paint getting on my surface. And I'm just going to run some glue close to the edge. And I recommend that you do use the liquid glue when using something as textured as this, because you want the glue to get into all of those little gullies for good adhesion. Now I can see that the watercolor paper did expand a little bit when it got wet, so now it's not as perfect. I wanted a little bit more of the Pretty Peacock showing, but that's okay. That's not bad. I don't mind that. It actually looks kind of nice. And now I'm going to take that and mount that on my card base. And you know, it feels so nice. These embossing folders really transform a simple piece of paper into something that's just so much more special. And that added texture that it gives to your cards, I think, really, really makes all the difference. So now we've got some of our seaweed pieces, and I'm just going to take a minute to poke out some of these little bits. There we go. You into frame here so you can see what I'm looking at and working on. So there are our embossed and die cut elements, but we're not going to stop there because now we're going to add some stamping. So I have the Sahara Sand ink pad. And with the Seaside Notions, you get this great little speckly, sandy kind of a stamp. So we're gonna add some texture to our piece here. So I'm just going to stamp and stamp off a few times. So we get something that starts to look like a textured seabed. And I also have this little clamshell. You can add a little bit of that on there. There it is. Put a couple. And I have a nice curled shell. Put that. Actually, what I'm going to do is I'm going to do a little bit of masking. So I'm just going to cover up a little bit of that shell there. There we go. So I get this kind of an effect. And then I'm going to take my brush again and my watercolors, and I'm just going to add a little bit of shadow just like that. Put a little accent in here. There we go. I'm going to put that aside for the moment. Now I have this pale pink scrap, and for this one I'm going to use this larger kind of a conch shell. I'll make a couple of these. I don't know if I'll use both, but there we go. And I'm going to cut these out. And the shapes of the shells in this stamp set are really easy shapes to cut out. So it just takes a few seconds to do that. There we go. Take that little point off there. I'll get a little bit closer there. Okay. All right. So there we go with that. Now I'm going to take my Wink of Stella. I'm going to add a little sparkle to my shells. Get a little more out. I want these to be really sparkly. There we go. That's better. Let me see if you can see that. A little bit, maybe. There you go. Missed a spot. Okay. Okay. Now, going back to my sandy bottom, what I'm going to do is I'm going to tear, using my thumbnail as a guide, and I'm just going to pull this paper around the shape of this seashell. Just gently pulling that away. And when I get about, I don't know, maybe half of the way down, I'm then going to pull the paper away and I'm going to make an irregular shape for the edge. Okay, so I've got something that looks like this. And I'm going to take my paints again and I'm just going to soften that white edge a little bit. Just hardly anything. There we go. So we're just about ready to assemble. But there's just one more thing that I want to do, and that is I'm going to take a piece of Calypso coral and my Calypso coral ink, and I'm just going to stamp a seahorse. I'm going to cut that out. This, you know, I'm not trying to be too exact here, but I am trying to give it just a little bit of an irregular edge to show those little ridges on his body and tail. I used to have seahorses in a tank when I was younger, and they were so beautiful. I had a pair. Male and a female, and sure enough, the male carried the babies in his pouch until they were ready to come out, and it was just so amazing to see that, the little tiny seahorses. Perfect miniature replicas of the adults, their little tails. Okay, so here's our little friend. Oh, let me get his tail a little bit better. This is where it gets a little harder to cut out, but just take a second to do it. Go. Okay, so there he is. And I am going to go ahead and sponge around the edges. Now, obviously, this is not one of our quick cards. But when you're in the mood to do something a little more artistic and spend a little more time to make something really special, this is a really fun way to do that. And let me think. Do I want to put Wink of Stella on that too? I don't think so. I think I'll just keep the Wink of Stella to the foreground. All right, so let's assemble some of these things that we've created. So using the liquid glue again, I'm just going to place some dots, just tiny dots in the intersections here where there's a little more paper. Get along here. And I'm just lightly tapping this down because I don't want it to be very flat. I want there to be some places where there is a little gap that makes a nice shadow, just to enhance the effect. Go. And let those overlap slightly. And let me see. I'm going to tear this little piece off and add this. Put this one on this side. Go. All right, so now we've got our background established. I'm going to take this little piece for the foreground and just glue this right down like so. Now my seahorse is going to be holding on to this little piece of seaweed here. So what I have to do is grab my snips. And then I'm just going to snip his tail into two pieces just for the minute and grab my dimensionals give that a snip. And then I'm going to put some glue towards the bottom there. And I'm just going to tuck that right in there. And move him over a little bit. So I don't want to cover up my seaweed back there too much. Okay, now I'm going to take that little extra bit from his tail and let that come out. Like so. Get under there. There we go. All right. Now for my seashells, my larger ones, I don't think I need both of them. So let me pick. I'll pick this one. And before I put that down, I'm going to take my Sahara sand ink, and I'm just going to sponge the edges a little bit. Where do I want this? I think I'll put it right here. Okay. Let me just move some of these things out of the way. Okay. And I think I want to add a little something here. So I'm going to go back to the stamp set and let me grab a scrap of paper. So I've got a little piece of the Sahara sand cardstock here, and I'm going to take my, where is he? I'm going to take the sand dollar. Oh, here it is. Okay, here's my sand dollar. And I'm just going to stamp that. Go. And we'll add a little wink of Stella to that. There we go. Okay, we're almost done now. There's our Seabed and our seahorse, but now what I want to do is I want to take some embellishments. So I've got some pearls. Can't have a seascape without a few pearls. Here, and then I'll grab some of these smaller ones. So there's our pearls, and these, by the way, are the pearl basic jewels. And then I'm also grabbing the elegant faceted gems, and I'm going to take a couple of the clear ones. And just add a couple of bubbles coming up here. Put another one over here. There we go. And then there are these kind of champagne colored ones. I'm going to take a couple of these smaller ones and just put them in the sand. There we go. So there is our little seascape. So I hope you enjoyed that. Oh, I do want to add something to the, don't go away folks, there's one more thing to do here. Can't forget our envelope. So I'm just going to take a couple of post-it notes and mask off. This section. There we go. And now I'm going to grab my Calypso Coral. And I'm going to use this nice coral stamp and just randomly put this design on our flap. And I'm also going to add a little bit to the inside, just like that. And I want to add a shell there too. So going back to the Sahara sand and just add this right there. And there is our underwater sea adventure card using both the 3D embossing as well as the die cuts and some watercolor. So this is definitely a little more of a avid crafting project, but well worth the while. I hope you enjoyed that, and I will see you on Wednesday for Watercolor Wednesday. And if you would like to subscribe to Notes from Dandelion Cottage to stay informed of all my upcoming classes, both paper crafting and watercolor classes, you can do that. Go to dandelioncottagedesign.com and subscribe to Notes.